one of America's foremost architects, Mr. Frank Lloyd Wright. Frank Lloyd Wright is our next guest, America's foremost architect, the man you read about recently in Life magazine. Mr. Wright, I don't think I've ever seen you looking better. You look very well rested after this trip.
Well, my dear boy, if I ever felt better, I couldn't stand it.
By the way, you are getting along in years, and you're one of the most active men I know around. What do you attribute to that?
You mean to say that 81 is getting along?
Getting along a little bit.
Well, if it's getting along, I'm getting along fine.
But I marvel at the way you get around. It's almost hard for me, a young fellow, to keep up with you.
Is that so? Well, that's hard to believe.
Mr. Wright,
I don't find it difficult to get around yet.
Mr. Wright, let's talk just a wee bit about your progressive architecture and ask you what you are looking forward to in your new designs.
Well, if I could make a prescription for London at the present time, having just seen it, I would say that if London is interested in modernizing herself and is interested in modern architecture, she should plant grass where every bomb fell and never allow one of those areas to be rebuilt.
In other words, in the entire bombed-out areas of London, of the Manchester and British places like that, you would spread the population out into the suburbs, more or less, and then fill in with parks and playgrounds.
Naturally. Grass, flowers, trees, where the bombs fell.
Is that the new method of designing houses?
Yes.
To give houses more land, more area?
Well, the open center is a new way of planning cities and planning almost everything else.
Have you had much contact with this new development in architecture whereby they build round buildings, circular?
Oh, yes, I built some myself, planned others. It's a very good form of building in concrete and steel because you can pre-stress the steel, and concrete naturally takes any form you want to give it.
We've been hearing a lot about Sunshine College down in Florida.
Sunshine College, that's a new term.
I believe it's one you designed.
I guess you mean Florida Southern
College.
Yeah,
that's it, except that now they call it, because of your own particular design, they call it a Sunshine College.
Well, that's not a bad name. We'll accept it.
I understand part of it is outdoor and part indoor.
Well, it's hard to tell where the indoors begins and the outdoors leave off.
Thought I was going to catch you and hear you say it's hard to tell where the design begins and ends.
Well, that too. We'll take that.
Don't you have a new industrial tower, too, the Johnson Wax Company?
Yes, the Johnson Wax Company have built a research laboratory on the vertical rather than on the horizontal.
I wonder if I could get an explanation of that.
You see, the average research laboratory has miles of ducts and service systems. And when you build a building flat on the ground, they run for miles and miles. But if you build a vertical stack and attach all these things directly to it, these laboratories, you made a great saving in labor, and it's quite a natural scheme for a research laboratory.
Do you have anything new coming up in the way of building materials that might radically change our architectural designs? I'm thinking especially of apartment houses now.
Well, of course, we have glass and steel, which the classics didn't have. The Greeks and the Romans, if they had, we wouldn't have to do any thinking now. We'd copy what they did.
More and more, we're getting away from the Greeks and the Roman architecture, aren't we?
That's a fortunate circumstance, and it's true, we are. And if our modern architecture means anything at all, it means that all that now is in the scrap heap.
You know, we look at houses today that were built 30 years ago, and they seem so old-fashioned. Do you think the houses we're building today, 30 years from now, will just be obsolete, and not obsolete, but, you know, so distant?
I hope they'll look old-fashioned.
In other words, we're always going to progress.
I hope we'll build better and better buildings, and we will if we get the principle of good building. If we merely take another style and take what's been done for its effects and copy it, we won't have it.
Well, is there a trend towards more rooms within a private residence?
No, the trend is the other way, to make the most of open space, to make the most of the open plan, to get all that you can of outdoors inside and inside outdoors that's within the limits of discretion.
Sounds real healthy, too.
It is healthy. The new house, the new plan, the open plan, as we call it, is an extremely healthy way to live.
Thank you very much, Frank Lloyd Wright, for chatting with us.
You're welcome.
Nice meeting you.
Caught me on the wing.
On the wing.